We're talking up to 15 feet of water.
This would be detrimental, yes. And we're still looking at that forecast here, even with the 5 o'clock update. You know, surge is the most widespread impact to both life and property that we see with hurricanes. And it's something that we're definitely concerned for with this upcoming hurricane. With storm surge, what's happening is that you have this hurricane forming and the pressure dropping over the ocean. And some of that pressure drop actually helps to pull the water upward. In addition, you have the strong hurricane wind pushing the water toward the shore. So you have pressure driven surge and then you have wind driven surge, creating a bubble of water. That is the total storm surge. Now the problem with the Gulf of Mexico is that the shape of the coastline leaves little room for the surge to actually spread. So that's why the same storm strength on the east coast of Florida would not create as much surge as it does on the west coast. Furthermore, the shallow slope of the seafloor on the west coast allows for more water to penetrate inland. That's why with this inundation forecast, especially for Tampa Bay, which is actually known as the most vulnerable spot to storm surge, we're looking at over 9 feet of surge into Tampa Bay. So that's something that could reach up to the second level of homes. It also looks to be a similar outlook, unfortunately, Erica, for the Fort Myers area.